Last year, I was designing a crocheted necklace. And I was using hand-spun chain ply on the fly out of pygora merino fiber. I really wanted the luster that silk gives, and it didn't have the silk in it. And I thought, how can I, since it's chain plied on the fly, how can I incorporate silk while into this mix to get that pop of sheen, that luster? And I thought, I wonder if I could just simply spin the silk along with the fiber. So I took a strand of silk and incorporated right as I spin, drafting out the fiber. Whatever kind of fiber you use, you can use stranded silk with it. I call this stranded spinning. This is the necklace that I designed and developed. This is chain plied with a strand of silk. I want to just put a little bit, you don't need much, over the hole, center that, and impale it with your shaft, because when you spin it, you'll spin clockwise. Because it's upside down, you'll want to spin it counterclockwise. Counterintuitive, I know, but that's the way it goes. Until you get long enough to go up to the top and do your half hitch. I need a little bit more length. See that silk? I'm using blue silk. Don't know if it's showing up very well. It's so fine. This is a 62 silk strand. You can use 122. You can double your silk strand. That's what I do for the workshop that I taught last fall on stranded spinning. See how just you draft your fiber back as normal and pull the silk strand forward as you draft back. And it's nicely incorporated. And yes, I am spinning clockwise. Just that optical illusion that happens. See, I just want to get that technique out there in the world. Stranded spinning. Make efficient use of your time and your materials. Isn't that cool? Have a blast!